In the Quran, ya akhwan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala classified the souls into three souls. An-nafs al-mutma'inna, the nafs, the soul that is mutma'inna, rested, relaxed, comfortable, pleased. The nafs al-lawwama, the soul that's constantly blaming itself, which is most of us. Why did you do that? How could you do that? And an-nafs al-ammara bis-su', the soul that commands evil. May Allah save us from that soul. So, is there a dua that Rasulullah ﷺ taught us to ask for a nafs mutma'inna, which is the best soul? This nafs al-mutma'inna is the soul that loves Allah. This soul loves to obey Allah. This soul is in constant remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. And nafs al-mutma'inna is in constant remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And nafs al-mutma'inna is the one that Allah mentioned in the Quran, أدخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي, in the last surah, in the last ayat of Surah Al-Fajr. طيب, listen to this beautiful dua, inshallah. And please, every time we learn a dua, it's not just about to mention it here. It's for us to memorize it and repeat it and say it in our sujood. Huh? Listen, Rasulullah ﷺ taught one of the sahaba, his name is Abu Umama Al-Bahili. He said, قل اللهم إني أسألك نفسا مطمئنة تؤمن بلقائك وترضى بقضائك وتقنع بعطائك. يا رب, يا الله, bless me with a nafs mutma'inna that believes that it is going to meet you and is pleased with whatever you decreed and content with whatever you bestowed. تؤمن بلقائك. Let's explain them. Ya Allah, bless me with a nafs mutma'inna. We all know this first part. تؤمن بلقائك. Believes in meeting Allah. Sheikh, we all believe we are meeting Allah. No. What that believes lead to. This is what we're talking about. We all believe that we are going to meet Allah. But what did that believe lead to? What did that believe drive us to? There's no way someone who believes is going to meet Allah and he buys and sells haram. There's no way someone believes and he's going to meet Allah, he will take the inheritance of his sister. There's no way someone believes is meeting Allah and he oppresses anyone else. What does that lead to? This iman in meeting Allah led me, it will lead me to become a better Muslim, to become a better believer. اللهم إني أسألك نفسا مطمئنة تؤمن بلقائك. This belief in meeting Allah will make me always ready. Always ready. It could be tomorrow. I'm done. Because don't think it's only, like Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم told us, that every single one of us qiyama, every one of us is qiyama, is when they die. Then there is the other meeting. But we will find out right away from the qabr. Either it will become a jannah or it will become nar. It's the first steps of the akhirah. تؤمن بلقائك وترضى بقضائك and is pleased with your qada. So many of us are so worried, always worried. Worried about the future, worried about the children, worried about the job, worried about this, worried about that. My dear beloved brothers and sisters, we do what we are supposed to do, what Allah ordered us to do, stay away from what He has prohibited, and we submit. Whatever Allah decreed, whether you see it or not, it is always, always khair. Always khair. If you don't see it now, you're gonna see it tomorrow, the day after, 5 years. It is always khair. تَرْضَى بِقَضَائِكَ. Ya Allah, I am pleased. Cancer stage 4, I am pleased. I have no children. Pleased. I am pleased with your qada, Ya Allah. I am content with your ata, because the rida and the qana'a are two words that are similar. Being content and being pleased is the same. But rida is more inclusive than qana'a. Because rida is all the time. Rida is before the problem took place, during the problem taking place, and after. Qana'a is usually after a problem took place. But the rida, pleasure with what Allah decreed, is all the time. So here I'm asking for both. Ya Allah, bless me with a soul that is mutmainna, tu'minu bi liqa'ik, wa tarda bi qada'ik, wa taqna'u bi ata'ik. And it is content, the contentment, ya akhwan, to be pleased. You are making $1,000 a week, $1,000 a month, alhamdulillah, I am doing my best, ya Allah. You're making 10,000, alhamdulillah. You are sick, alhamdulillah. Your son is sick, your daughter is sick, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. Ya Allah, I did not do anything to cause that. This is your qada, and I am pleased, ya Allah, with whatever you decreed. Look how beautiful is this dua. So repeat after me, ya akhwan. Allahumma, inni as'aluka nafsan mutmainna. تؤمن بلقائك وترضى بقضائك وتقنع بعطائك. Tonight is the night of Jumu'ah, where our beloved عليه الصلاة والسلام say, make a lot of salat upon me. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. We'll see you at 5:30 inshallah for salat al-fajr. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما.